A semi-truck carrying lithium-ion batteries flipped over on a remote section of highway in California, and it caused delays for almost 2 days. On Friday morning at 6 a.m., a semi-truck traveling on I-15 northbound rolled over, and it was carrying an energy storage system. This energy storage system, I talk about them all the time, was designed to fit in something the size of a shipping container. In fact, it looked a lot like a shipping container, except you can see the door on the backside of this here. This unit ended up catching on fire and was off-gassing, causing severe hazard for both first responders and people in the area. First responders ended up closing north and southbound I-15. This section of highway connects Los Angeles with Las Vegas and is quite heavily traveled. And unfortunately, it caused major backups. Eventually, they did open up southbound traffic, but they left northbound closed for quite some time because there isn't a lot you can do when this type of unit is on fire. Realistically, you have to stand back and isolate. Typically, these types of energy storage systems are tied into the grid. They're located next to a substation. During peak demand hours, they supplement the grid, giving power out to the grid, and overnight they charge them. But they also use these types of energy storage systems as portable energy storage for, let's say, large events. If you have a large concert or a large sporting event, they'll bring these energy storage systems in. They'll have portable chargers on them meant to charge electric vehicles. So there's multiple uses for these types of energy storage systems. These energy storage systems are designed to be on flat ground. They're not really designed to be moving around. Unlike an electric vehicle where we design those vehicles for impact to protect the batteries, these types of systems aren't designed like that. So likely when this unit rolled over, battery modules were knocked loose. You had mechanical damage that damaged the battery modules, caused bus bars to short out, and caused thermal runaway inside, causing those batteries to off-gas. And when those batteries off-gas, it's a flammable gas coming out of the batteries. There's a severe deflagration explosion hazard. There were reports that liquid was leaking from the unit, and that likely wasn't too much of a hazard. It should be a glycol mixture that was leaking out that's meant for the thermal management of the batteries. And thermal management is very critical, especially out in the hot desert. You want to keep these battery cells cool, and that's tough to do when this unit's on its side and damaged. In fact, while that was laying out in the desert on its side, outside temperatures were over 110 degrees, inside that box, likely much higher. Eventually, fire crews got heavy equipment on scene because they wanted to move this unit away from the highway. It's a very difficult thing to do because this is about 75,000 pounds worth of batteries. They were able to drag this unit away from the highway, opening it up right around 3 a.m. Sunday morning. So the highway was closed for just about 48 hours. When these types of energy storage systems are on fire, there is a severe hazard, and fire crews did the right thing by isolating and keeping the highway closed. It's unfortunate because there's a lot of people that were stuck on the highway and traffic backed up for miles, people running out of gas and having problems, especially with temperatures over 110 degrees. Ultimately, this energy storage system will be a hazard for a few more days. And even though they got this unit off the side of the highway, they still had one fire crew sitting on it, making sure everything was okay. While doing research for this video, I came across another incident that just happened today where a semi-truck hauling one of these energy storage systems was pulling into a gas station and rolled over on its side. Thankfully, because of the low-speed impact on that one, there was no fire. To understand the scale of how bad these fires can get, check out this video right here.